Hey everybody, Dutch Sinse here. 2:33 p.m. Central Time on Saturday, October 19th, 2013. And we're looking at Earthquake 3D here, which is a USGS feed of the most recent earthquakes. You can see it, a 6.5 struck here in Baja Mexico, north central Mexico, just south of Arizona and California. And we were expecting this. I put out a warning yesterday. And here we are on Facebook. I'll put a link down below to this so you guys can see it. Here it is. Cannot be edited, cannot be changed. I let everyone know this is an area to watch, and I'll just read it to you here. Showing a line of mid 4.0 earthquakes reaching up the eastern Pacific towards Mexico, also south towards Argentina, Chile. Possible larger movement around this cluster developing. Could be on the northern flank of this line, North Mexico, Baja. Also, USA showing west coast activity, but nothing in the Midwest of any size over 2.5. I'd say we most likely need to watch for several fracking injection well earthquakes at about 3 miles deep in the near-term future, next couple days or less. Now here's the picture I shared. It was put out, 123 other people liked it, shared all over the place, and it's multiple 4.0s that reached from South America all the way up here to South Mexico, silent area here in Baja. This led me to say, watch that area. This movement around the area shows that this area here, where the silence is occurring, is going to be moving, and most likely large, because it hasn't kept up with the adjacent areas. It's almost like an arrow is pointing right towards the area to watch. Now that's of course not happening, but you can watch this area and see the clusters around there and know that there's going to be follow-up movement. Okay, now let's go look at Earthquake 3D here really quick. In the last 48 hours, 24 specifically, we saw 2.5 and 2.9 at the fracking operations, 3.7, 3.4, and a 3.7 in Wyoming near Yellowstone and south of Yellowstone, and then there it is, the 6.5 we were expecting to see. And again, the reason we were expecting to see that is because pressure transfer. I've got geologists coming over to my other videos on my YouTube channel telling me that there is no such thing as pressure transfer, and that earthquakes that happen are unrelated. So when we see a 7.0 happen over here in Sumatra, let's say, and within a few hours we have a 7.0 that happens over here on the East Pacific, let's say down near Colombia, they're saying those two are not related, even though they're on the opposite sides of the same plate, and the plate is obviously moving, and you can see the movement happening if you use programs like this, let's say, or others. You can see the progression of earthquakes. Just take it down over the past few days. Watch them pop off. You can see it building towards the 6.5 right there where it was silent. All these 4.0s all the way down the entire plate. The pressure there has to be tremendous. And the fracking operation. Again, that's a man-made operation where they're pumping water deep down into the earth. Let's just go ahead and get the stats on this, see if it was at 3 miles, like we were expecting. There you go, 3.1 miles. That's happening because the craton itself is being displaced. Even though geologists will tell us that it's not happening, you can see it happen over the course of days. You can see the earthquakes progress from west to east. Not east to west, it's happening from west to east, which means the subduction itself is not able to keep up with all this movement going on over here in the West Pacific. And that's due to the plate fracture at the Indo-Australian plate that caused this whole thing, this whole mess, to begin, what, 2.5 years ago now. So much love, guys. Hang in there. I just wanted to show you that I did put out that warning. I'm not trying to toot my own horn too hard, but it was put out. This is something that we can all do. We can watch where the earthquake clusters are occurring and then follow up and see if any large-scale movement happens in the areas surrounding those cluster points. It seems to be a pattern at this point, which indicates that the whole theory that's being proposed by the establishment, the professionals, saying that pressure transfer doesn't occur is wrong, and that they need to immediately reassess pressure transfer happening amongst plates, because it's obvious that it is happening. This could lead to somebody being able to correctly forecast earthquakes. Imagine if professionals took that into account. That might change everything in the way they're able to predict earthquakes. I would urge you professionals to look into this. How was I able to predict that an earthquake would happen right there in the near term? And I'm not a professional. I'm just online. But I'm trying to show people what I see. I've been covering it for 3 years straight now, almost every day, watching the progression of earthquakes, and there is a pattern. And the pattern is pressure transfer. It's wild. Much love, guys. Be safe. Hang in there.